Hello, everybody. Welcome back into the channel. My name is KL. Today, I am watching a heist movie, and that is Ocean's 11 from 2001. Thank you so much to Gunnar for picking this. He was the winner of my Member of the Month draw over on Patreon for the month of November. That is a thing I do monthly where all eligible patrons go into a wheel spin. It's completely random, and the winner can either pick a specific movie for me to watch and react to, or they can pick a list of movies, and it goes into a poll for the whole Patreon community to vote on. It's one of my favorite benefits of my Patreon because I have watched some excellent movies. Not all of them have come to the channel, and not all of them will come to the channel, so some of them are exclusives. But this one, from the moment that Gunnar told me the name, I was like, yep, that's probably a good one for the channel. I think that a bunch of people would be interested in watching the reactions, so I hope that's the case. Obviously, if you're here watching right now, thank you so much for joining me. All I know about this movie is that it's a heist movie, and it stars Brad Pitt, I believe, and I think George Clooney, but I'm not 100% confident on that one. This movie has been around for quite some time. Why I haven't watched it, I have no idea, but I'm very excited to check it out today, so thank you for being here. As always, if you're not a fan of this chopped up edited version, you'd rather watch the whole movie along with me, bring your own copy of Ocean's 11 over to my Patreon, and you can find this reaction either by signing up as a member or you can look for it in my Patreon shop. All right, with the intro out of the way, it is time to press play. Prison. We're listening to a prison.
Good morning.
Morning.
Hello, George.
Daniel Ocean.
Thank you.
Ocean. Ocean's 11.
While this was your first conviction, you have been implicated, though never charged, in over a dozen other confidence schemes and frauds.
I was never charged.
He has really nice groomed hair for being in prison.
Was there a reason you simply got caught this time?
My wife left me. I got into a self-destructive pattern. I don't think she'd do it again just for kicks.
What do you think you would do if released?
Is that what we're about to find out? Or are we getting the story of how he ended up in prison? Oh no, he's leaving prison. Cool. Hopefully he doesn't end up back in prison at the end of the movie, because that would suck. Curious what the 11 part means.
Ships, please.
Sure. All right, going on break now.
How are you, sir?
Hello, Frank.
You must have me confused with someone else. My name is Ramon.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
You might want to try the lounge at the Caesars. It gets busy after 1 o'clock.
Thanks, Ramon.
Thank you.
Did they know each other previously? Felt like they did.
Frank Catton can't get past the gaming board. You just got out?
This afternoon.
You have a plan already?
Are you kidding? I just became a citizen again.
Danny Ocean, I was told to contact you within 24 hours. No, sir, I haven't been getting in any trouble. I wouldn't even think about leaving the state.
Hey, there he is.
Are you incorporated? If you're not, you should really think about it, because I was talking to my manager last night.
Is that Topher Grace?
You know what? They're both named Bernie.
It is. Also, I love Brad Pitt's early 2000 bleached tips hair. Oh, wow. I haven't seen that actor in so long.
Shane?
Oh, and Shane? Walk to Remember guy.
Oh. Okay.
God, he's still cute.
How you bet is your business. You want to make them think you're betting for a reason.
Yeah, thanks, man. All right.
All right, how many? Four. You don't want four. You want to fold.
What are you doing?
And, you're done. Shane, you got three pairs.
Yeah.
You can't have three pairs.
Are they using the actors' like actual first names?
Reds.
Yeah.
Look at this
what up,
guy.
Dog?
All right.
Yeah.
I told you.
I promised I was gonna kick you.
It's hard to do, isn't it?
Oh, hey, Russ, we got another player, if that's cool with you.
Two cards.
Do they know each other?
Pick one, but you can't. My fence seemed confident enough.
If you're dealing in cash, you don't need a fence.
People lack vision.
Guys, what's the first lesson in poker?
Leave emotion at the door.
That's right, Topher.
They are using the actors' names. I don't know this guy, though.
500 of my own.
That's a very handsome bet, Josh. But be careful. We don't want to push him too high too fast.
I'll see you 500. Raise it 2,000.
He's trying to buy his way out of his bluff.
I don't understand poker. My dad used to play a lot, but...
Not sure what four nines does, but the ace, I think, is pretty high.
Dude!
Someone explained it to me a long time ago, but it's hard to remember things that you don't really have interest in, you know?
So how was the clink? Did you get the cookies I sent?
Why do you think I came to see you first?
I love this filming perspective.
It's never been done before, so I need planning, a large crew, 8 figures each.
8 figures each. Crazy.
You want to knock over a casino?
3 casinos? This is a casino heist?
The vault at the Bellagio.
If I'm reading this right, this is probably the least accessible vault ever designed.
Yep. These feed into the cages at the Mirage, the MGM Grand, but every dime ends up there.
These are Terry Benedict's places.
You think you'll mind?
More than somewhat. Let's say you're looking at it. Bosky, a Jim Brown, a Miss Daisy, 2 Jethros, and Leon Spinks.
Don't know what these mean.
Benedict's got a long list of enemies.
Reuben.
Reuben.
Hey, you guys done up here? Find what you want?
These guys have friends everywhere.
I need a reason. Don't seem
the
like
reason it. Why?
Why do this?
Why not do it? Because yesterday I walked out of the joint after losing 4 years of my life, and you're cold decking teen beat cover boys. Play long enough, you never change the stakes, the house takes you. When that perfect hand comes along, you bet big, and then you take the house.
Been practicing this speech, hadn't
you? A little bit, did I rush it? Felt like I rushed.
No, it was good, I liked it. Teen beat things, Marsh. I wonder what Reuben will say.
You're out of your goddamn minds.
That was a fun transition.
I know more about casino security than any man alive. I invented it, and it cannot be beaten.
This guy will always be Monica and Ross's dad from Friends. It's crazy seeing him like
okay. This. Bad example. You know the 3 most successful robberies in the history of Vegas? Henselneck grabs a lockbox at the Horseshoe. He got 2 steps closer to the door than any living soul before him. Flamingo in 71. This guy actually tasted fresh oxygen before they grabbed him.
Fresh oxygen.
And the closest any man has ever come was outside of Caesar's in 87. He came, he grabbed, they conquered. But what am I saying? You guys are pros.
Plus, they plan on having like a whole team for this, right? Feels like the other 3 were just on their own.
Our eyes were bigger than our stomachs. Thank you. For lunch.
Look, just out of curiosity, which casinos did you geniuses pick to rob?
What do you got against Terry Benedict?
What do you have against him? That's the question.
He torpedoed my casino. Muscled me out.
Does that mean you're in?
Now he's gonna blow it up next month to make way for some gaudy monstrosity. This sort of thing used to be civilized. You'd hit a guy, he'd whack you, done. But with Benedict, he better not know you're involved. You're gonna need a crew as nuts as you are.
Does that mean you're in?
Who do you got in mind?
All right, who's
maybe
in?
Maybe not.
Banksy has developed a bad case of bronchitis and is putting in for a transfer to warmer climates. What about drivers?
I talked to the Molloys yesterday.
No, little girl. You're like a little girl.
Relax.
I'm gonna do this all day. Don't.
I'm excited for this movie because I just spent time in Vegas for TwitchCon back in October. So Vegas is like fresh on the brain, we'll call it. What a stupidly expensive place, though. At least just on the strip. Literally walk 2 blocks off the strip and you can find a reasonable priced restaurant with like reasonable drinks, reasonable food. Strip is so overpriced because they can.
Bashers in town.
There might be an issue with availability.
All right, chaps.
Oh, leave it out.
Well, that didn't go so well.
Hang on. Are you accusing me of booby trapping?
Booby traps are Mr. Tar's style. Isn't that right?
Peck, ATF. Did you search this scumbag? Booby traps on his person? Not just for weapons. Go find Griggs. Tell him I need to see him.
Who?
Just find him, will ya?
Hey, Ben. I put something together before I just slipped him.
It's done.
It'll be nice working with proper villains again.
Everybody down! Get it!
Oh my gosh. So these 2 have like mega experience doing this because they know all of these people and clearly worked with them before. Oh, so does Ocean's 11, him plus 11 others to make the group that does the heist?
Which one's the amazing Yen?
The little Chinese guy.
Who else is on the list?
He is the list.
We got a grease man.
I'm so excited to see what all these people do and how this all comes together.
We need Saul.
He won't do it. Got out of the game a year ago. Ulcers.
You could ask him.
Hey, I could ask him.
I saw you before you even got up this morning.
How you been, Saul?
Never better.
What's with the orange?
My doctor says I need vitamins.
So why don't you take vitamins?
Maybe he just wants to eat an orange.
I got a duplex now. I got wall to wall and a goldfish.
This guy feels like he needs to be retired.
I've changed.
Guys like us don't change, Saul.
Quit conning me. Tell me what the scam is.
This man is shocked. I also like that he seems to feel so confident that he'll say yes, that he just got up and walked away.
Saul makes 10. 10 ought to do it, don't you think?
11?
You think we need one more? All right, we'll get one more.
Ocean's 10 just doesn't have the same ring to it. Although I feel like there's more than one of these movies, isn't there? Isn't there like an Ocean's 12? Is that Matt Damon? This like, that style of filming was cool. Like stop motion kind of.
Hello, Linus. Whose is this?
Who are you?
A friend of Bobby Caldwell's. You're either in or you're out. Well, Bobby has a lot of faith in you.
Fathers are like that. No, he didn't tell you. He didn't want me trading on his name.
Oh,
if you
shit.
Do this job, he'll be trading on yours. If you don't, we'll find somebody else who won't be quite as good, and you can go back to feeling up stockbrokers. Can you get the check, please?
Las Vegas, huh?
He's so young in this.
What I'm about to propose to you is both highly lucrative and highly dangerous. Doesn't seem like your particular brand of vodka. Have a safe journey, no hard feelings. Otherwise, come with me. This is the vault at the Bellagio. We're gonna rob it.
Smash and grab job, huh?
Slightly more complicated than that.
Oh, yeah.
He was just saying.
First, we have to get within the casino cages through these doors, each of which requires a different six-digit code changed every 12 hours. The elevator won't move without authorized fingerprint identification.
Which we can't fake.
And vocal confirmation. The elevator shaft is rigged with motion detectors. Once we get down the shaft, though, then it's a piece of cake. Two more guards with Uzis and the most elaborate vault door ever conceived by man.
You said something about good news?
Yeah.
Also, is that Casey Affleck?
$150 million without breaking a sweat. Now, there are 11 of us, each with an equal share. You do the math.
Say we get into the cage, and down the elevator we can't move, and past the guards with the guns, and into the vault we can't open.
Without being seen by the cameras.
We're just supposed to walk out of there with $150 million in cash on us without getting stopped?
Yeah, what's the plan for that?
Yeah.
No plan.
Okay.
All right, then.
All right, here's how we begin. First task, reconnaissance.
I'm gonna be studying.
Every guard, every watcher, anyone with a security pass.
All right.
Cool. I think she really likes me.
I want you guys to know these casinos, built as labyrinths to keep people in.
Yes, they are. Casinos are so confusing to walk through.
Second task, power.
You want broke, blind, a bedlam.
How about all three? Third task, surveillance.
It's not the least accessible system I've seen, but it's close. And it's definitely a black bag job. They employ an in-house technician?
Two. And one of them's lonely.
Sneaky.
Say hi to your mom for me.
Say it yourself. She'll be on stage in 5 minutes.
This movie's transitions are so fun.
Watch it, bud.
You going bud, pal?
Who you calling pal, friend?
Who you going friend?
We have a visual impairment.
Copy that, I see them.
Good distraction.
To me. You got in my way! I was trying to deliver my balloon!
And we're up and running.
He's gonna go in there, but he won't be able to tell if anything's been done, right? Oh no. Oh no. Even the back rooms, the authorized sections, are a maze too.
Excuse me.
Did he manage to actually find that?
Drop this.
Oh.
Oh, thank you.
Take care.
Whew. Relief.
Fourth task, construction. We need to build an exact working replica of the Bellagio vault.
What? Wow. I mean, makes sense. Plus, when you break down the $150 million by hours worked, it's a really good hourly rate. Even factoring in all this construction and practice and everything, right?
Six tasks, transport.
Well, I am sorry, but 18.5 apiece is the best offer that I can make.
Yes, did them like a jean. Man, you got some lovely hands here. Do you moisturize?
I'm sorry?
Now, my sister, she uses aloe vera.
If you were willing to pay cash,
yeah,
I might be able to drop that down to, say, 16. Each?
They told me to come see you.
Oh, did they? Okay, well,
Oh, gosh. That'd be so uncomfortable.
So are you sure you're ready to do this?
If you ever ask me that question again, Daniel, you will not wake up the following morning.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, I'll say. He definitely wants you to stop fucking asking.
Lyman. Zerga. My name is Lyman.
Lyman Zerga.
My name is Lyman Zerga.
Good afternoon, Mr. Benedict. Right,
he arrives at the Bellagio every day at 2 p.m. Offices are upstairs. He works hard, hits the lobby floor at 7 on the nose. Spends 3 minutes on the floor with his casino manager. Benedict likes to know what's going on in his casinos, likes to be in control. There's rarely an incident he doesn't know about or handle personally. Spends a few minutes glad-handing the high rollers. He's fluent in Spanish, German, and Italian, and he's taking Japanese lessons. He's getting pretty good at it.
I am also learning Japanese.
Contents, the day's take, and new security codes. Then he heads to the restaurant.
That portfolio contains codes to all the kids' doors?
Mm-hmm. And 2 minutes after they've been changed, he's got them in his hand. I tell you, you guys really can't pick them.
You scared?
You suicidal?
Only in the morning.
Now comes a girl. Here she is. This is just the best part of my day.
Miss Julia. She looks fab in red. Red is definitely her color.
I still don't know if we can use her yet. Actually, I haven't even caught her name.
Like, bring her on the team?
Her name is Tess.
Tess. Wow, their practice setup looks legit.
We have to talk.
Okay.
Now.
What's up?
Tell me this is not about screwing the guy who's screwing your wife.
Ex-wife.
Tell me.
It's not about that. It's not entirely about that. Russ, you remember when we first got into this business? We said we were going to play the game like we had nothing to lose. I lost someone. That's why I'm here.
So this is personal.
Now we're stealing two things. If you can't have both, what you gonna choose? Test does not split 11 ways.
If everything goes to plan, then I won't be the one that has to make that choice.
Interesting. All right.
You like it?
I like that you like it.
That's a no. I don't like it.
In my hotel, there's always somebody watching. I'll see you tonight.
I felt really cold.
I wouldn't get into Terry Benedict. He doesn't fool around.
Lyman Zerg in the third position. Wish to speak to you privately.
Businessman of some kind. Word is he does primary in arms. One of the biggest.
Never heard of him.
Okay, how's this gonna go?
You're 30 seconds late. I was about to send out a search.
Hello, Tess.
What are you doing here?
I'm out. You remember the day that I went for cigarettes and didn't come back? You must have noticed.
I don't smoke, don't sit.
You're not wearing your ring.
Well,
I don't have a husband, or didn't you get the papers?
My last day inside.
I told you I'd write. Go now, before...
What? Benedict?
Danny.
Tess, you're doing a great job curating the museum. I came here for you.
You're a thief and a liar.
I don't do that anymore.
Steal.
Lie.
I'm with someone now who doesn't have to make that kind of distinction.
No, he's very clear on both.
You know what your problem is?
I only have one.
You've met too many people like you. I'm with Terry now.
Does he make you laugh?
He doesn't make me cry.
Ooh, those are two very good lines right there. I don't think he makes her laugh, though. He doesn't seem like that kind of guy to me. What a great scene between those two. I loved that.
I have a package arriving here that evening. Black briefcase, standard size, the contents of which is very valuable to me.
I'll put it in the house safe for you.
I need something more secure. What can you offer me?
The big vault, right?
How am I going to get my 5 years back, Danny?
You can't. You don't love me anymore. You want to make a life with someone else? Fine. I'm going to have to live with that, but not him.
Spoken like a true ex-husband.
I'm not joking, Tess.
I'm not laughing, Danny. Do you remember what I said to you when we first met?
You said that I better know what I'm doing.
Do you? Because truly, you should walk out the door if you don't.
I know what I'm doing.
What are you doing?
Terry, meet my ex-husband.
Danny Ocean.
You recently were released from prison, is that correct?
That's right.
Danny was just about
to. I just stopped by to say hi to Tess for old time's sake.
Stay and have a drink.
You can't.
I don't imagine we'll be seeing Mr. Ocean anytime soon, right?
You never know.
I know everything that's happening in my hotels.
This is very awkward now. I can feel the awkward level. The awkward level is high. Is this what's gonna go in that thing of his that he wants Terry to put away?
Saul's package arrives at 7:05. Linus grabs our codes. Yen gets locked in and we're committed. From this point, we have 30 minutes to blow the power.
Or he suffocates. Damn.
Once the electricity goes, all access points to the vault and its elevator will automatically shut down for 2 minutes. That's when we make our move.
Oh my gosh.
You have to get from there to the door without touching the floor. What do you do?
Window arrival, boys.
We're in deep shit. They did the same what I would have done, only they did it by accident. Problem is now they know their weakness and they're sorting it out. They're fixing it. So unless we intend to do this job in Reno, we're in Barney. Barney Rubble. Trouble!
We could always...
By tomorrow?
We could use a pinch.
What's a pinch? It
creates like a cardiac arrest for any broadband electrical circuitry. Or better yet, a pinch is a bomb. No, but without the bomb, it's a similar electromagnetic pulse, but without the fuss of mass destruction and death.
How long?
About 30 seconds.
Could a pinch knock out the power of an entire city?
Yeah, I think it might.
Okay.
There's only one pinch in the world big enough to manage it.
I feel like there's so much of this that I don't understand, but I'm just along for the ride. I like all the planning and I'm excited to see it carried out. I do feel like they're going to run into some kind of problem. Like this is already first problem. Also, I'm not sure what he is thinking about all this because like he was following Danny for a while and then now he's kind of just, you know, anyway, it's hard to get a read on him.
Where's Linus?
It's crazy they didn't notice him when...
Oh, would you look at his donut.
What is he...
Back it up.
You stupid bastard!
Yeah, that was not the vibe right there.
Jesus!
Oh no.
Lose focus in this game for one second.
I got it.
It gets hurt.
I hope his fingers aren't broken.
Where the hell are they?
We'll be here.
They will be here.
Schmuck.
You boys have a nice trip?
Sort of.
We have a problem. You've been red flagged. It means the moment you set foot in that casino floor, they'll be watching you.
Shouldn't have done that.
Any idea how this happened?
Well...
He's been chasing Benedict's girl. The two of them got in an argument 2 nights ago.
Oh, that? Oh, that's what... Yeah, okay.
I was concerned you couldn't leave Tesla alone. I'm sorry. I didn't know if it would sting you, but it did. You're out, Danny.
He's out?
His involvement puts us all at risk.
This is not your call.
When you put her before us, you made it mine.
This is my job.
Who's gonna trigger the vault?
Kid, you up for it? I can do it. Locate the others, let them know the change of plan.
Tess is with Benedict now? She's too tall for him.
What's that mean?
What are you thinking about?
You.
Bet. Or doubt, rather.
Don't touch your tie. Look at me. I ask you a question. You have to think of the answer. Where do you look? You look down, they know you're lying. And up, they know you don't know the truth. Don't shift your weight. Be funny, but don't make him laugh. Don't, under any circumstance.
Russ.
Yeah?
Can you take a look at this?
Oh, he's so nervous. I mean, I would be too. And I'm also somebody like, I look up and down constantly when I talk, left to right, up, down, like, I'm always looking all over the place.
Saul?
Don't ask him if he's ready.
It's time.
Good. Good way to handle that. Also, I love the red vest. It's bright. Sharp. You're good, you got this.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Let's do it.
Mm-hmm. Let's do it. All right, I'm excited.
Piling into the MGM Grand Garden Arena, the two best heavyweights in the world.
It's a very busy night for me. Are we on schedule?
I have no reason to suspect otherwise.
18, Blackjack.
Why, Mr. Wall, Stella, Mr. Ocean's in the West slots.
Saul Bloom, is that you? Remember from Saratoga?
Oh, no.
Mikhail, Vladimir.
Hey! Hey, stop!
feel like he's suspicious now.
I cannot actually allow you to accompany the briefcase into the vault.
Why not?
Insurance for one, security another, but most of all, I just don't trust you.
Two plain clothes on the ocean. He's in the Kino bar now.
He will arrange for your briefcase to be stored inside our vault while you watch on a security monitor. Those are my terms, yes or no.
You leave me no choice.
Good.
I feel like Benedict can just go and like look up that name now, right? The name that the guy was yelling, the Saul name. Will he? I mean, there was internet in 2001, so. Oh my gosh, these two guys are doing everything. You got this, dude.
You'll do fine. But don't screw up.
No pressure.
You ready?
Don't let me keep you.
Linus, you're up.
Hi, Sheldon Willis. Nevada Gaming Commission.
Anything for the NGC?
All right, so far so good. He's selling it, I think.
Amazing.
The way he just slides in there, though.
Want something to read? Magazine? Counting down. 30 minutes of breathing time starts now.
I could never be in something where they could tell me how much breathing time I have left. I don't have claustrophobia, but that would give me claustrophobia.
You've been at the commission long?
Yeah, about 18 months.
You know how Lindley over there worked with him at all?
Not since he died last year. Ramon Escalante?
Yes.
It's come to our attention. I mean, you applied for this position.
I think it'll be better if we speak off the floor.
You are up to something, Danny. What? You're pulling a job, aren't you? You won't win me back.
Tess, I just came to say goodbye.
Change of attitude right there.
Goodbye.
You'd be good.
Mr. Benedict would like to see you.
I thought he might.
Mr. Benedict, I'm afraid you've been employing an ex-convict.
He sees goddamn cracker.
Excuse me?
You heard what I said. You definitely won't let me deal the cars. You might as well call it White Jack.
We at the NGC have always supported the hiring of colored...
I didn't mean...
Okay, come on, sit down.
Okay, that was slick. I was waiting for it. I was like, when is it gonna happen?
Card.
Oh, God, I think I lost my card.
Are you serious?
Just tell me, where did this go?
High roller's room.
To the vault.
There's your briefcase now, Mr. Zerga.
That's my cue.
I'm so nervous that there's gonna be a big hiccup. I'm worried about the guy, the circus man in the thing that only has a certain amount of breathing time. I'm kind of nervous about Saul and that whole thing, the guy recognizing him and potential, you know, consequences of that. And I'm also worried about Linus, even though I don't feel like I have to be.
This man over the premises. Don't ever set foot in my casino again.
Crap!
Oh, dear God. Oh, I forgot my pager. I left it.
You know your way back?
I do.
Good.
How much longer you figure Mr. Benedict's gonna be? No cameras in this room, huh? He's not coming, is he?
Okay.
We're gonna step outside now. Leave you two alone to talk things over.
Messy.
Oh, but, no one gets pardoned.
The replica they built was... No.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no.
Is that satisfying, Mr. Zerga?
I am very satisfied.
Oh, my gosh. This guy is sweating. Briefcase on that's going to be a problem because nothing can go on the floor, right? The door lifts so that it will...
How's your wife?
Pregnant again.
Oh, they know each other? Oh, my gosh. Amazing. Julie Roberts also looks good in gold. I feel like she can rock any color.
Who's that guy? At 31, I got a bogey in West Corridor.
Sorry.
Going to video?
We have a man down and he appears to be unconscious.
Oh my gosh, remembering all these steps though. I know they've been talking about it for a while, but still.
Oh!
You really didn't think I was gonna sit this one out, did you?
What, you didn't trust me?
Oh my gosh.
Now.
Yeah, no kidding. I'm worried about Saul's briefcase, though, and that guy in the thing.
Someone call for a doctor?
Is
How'd you get here?
We give a friend a couple million.
Oh, come on. You know, why don't you just tell me? Why do you put me through all this?
There's the fun in that.
I'm sorry. We've lost him.
Come on, get up!
Honestly, if someone offered me $2 million to act, I'd do it too.
These things are gonna hold us, right?
They should.
Oh my gosh.
Livingston, we're set.
Livingston, we're set.
Basher, we're set.
Hang on a minute, Chief.
We don't have a minute. Yen's gonna suffocate.
Wow. Wow. There's no backup generators anywhere for anything?
Go.
Or are they doing that before they kick in? There we go. Every table. Just say every table's been breached. Grab it. Grab the thing. Jesus. That was close. That reminded me of shuffleboard.
You think Yen made it out okay?
I'm sure he'll be fine.
Gosh, that was close. This is the most nervous I've been. Oh, that's what those were. Why did I not realize that?
Where we at, boys? Pins and floor sensors now.
Count me down from 20.
No.
Do not blow the door. Linus, can you read me?
2.
How the hell did they get all this out? Because we really haven't talked about that.
Rusty, you're up.
This isn't mine.
May I have a word with Mr. Benedict?
Who the hell is this?
The man who's robbing you.
What the hell's going on in the vault?
Nothing, sir.
I'm afraid you're mistaken.
Keep watching.
Find out how much money we have down there.
Yes, sir.
Oh, she knows.
You broke into my vault. Congratulations. You're a dead man.
Do you believe I'm gonna allow you to parade bags full of my money out my casino door?
No. You're gonna carry it out for us.
Why would I do that?
What?
Take a closer look at your monitor.
You have a little over 160 million in your vault tonight. We're only packing up about half that.
You let our 80 million go, and you get to keep yours. That's the deal. You try and stop us, we'll blow both cash limits. You can lose $80 million tonight secretly, or you can lose $160 million publicly. Hi.
Make the call.
911 emergency response.
Where's Danny?
Danny's fine. He's in good form.
We have 3 men with explosives who have taken control of our vault.
It's all right, Des.
You have a deal.
I promise. Fantastic. Here's what you do.
Guys in the vault will deposit 6 bags into the vault elevator. 3 of your guards will pick up the bags and carry them out into the casino.
If there's any indication a switch has been made, we'll blow the money in the bags and the money in the vault.
He's in the casino by the slots.
Of course I'm in the casino.
I find it interesting that they're like outing themselves.
Your guards will load the bags into the van's rear. My men will exit the building. And once their safety is confirmed, you will get your vault back.
Our team is here. I have complied with your every request. Would you agree?
I would.
Because now I have one of my own. Run and hide, asshole. That is all that I ask.
Our guys say that van is headed toward McCarran Airport.
Get everybody in position. I want my vault back before that van hits the tarmac.
Prepare to cut power. Reaching elevator doors now.
Guys, someone's here! Someone's here! Hit them down, now!
That appears a high explosive incendiary device has been detonated. Has been detonated.
Tell him to take the van. I'm going down there. And find that honey hooked into my system!
Yes, sir.
Get out of the van now!
So who is this gonna be?
Sir, our search has yielded no suspects. Nor were we able to determine at this time how they entered or exited the premises.
Nice. What a slick operation.
Walsh, where are we with a van?
Well... Amazing.
There's nobody inside.
Oh, sorry. Oop.
Enough monkey business. Do it already.
Are they blowing it up? I don't know what they're digging. I don't know what they're gonna do. Oh yeah.
And they say that there was no money in the bag, sir. They say the bags were filled with flyers, sir.
This is crazy.
Cue up the tape to the robbery.
Yes, sir. I'm looking at the tape now.
So this was filmed in their, like, mock-up one, right?
No, it doesn't. I don't understand.
Somebody made a duplicate of my vault, and what we saw on the monitor wasn't actually happening.
Damn.
What happened to all that money?
Make the call.
911 emergency response.
Oh my gosh.
That goggles on.
Clear.
This is so good.
guys, someone's here! Take him down, now!
Amazing. Slick AF, these guys. He's piecing it all together in his head. I feel like he should be impressed. I think he is impressed. Oh, gosh. Oh, slick. Except he's not going to be beat up, unless he did beat him up a little bit. Oh, okay. Yeah, there's a little.
Do you have a hand in this?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You're free to go.
I wasn't expecting him to be in there, but of course he'd have to be.
What happened, Benedict? Did you get robbed or something?
Where is my money?
What if I told you I could get your money back? If you give up Tess, what would you say?
I would say yes.
Wow.
You give me 72 hours, I'll find out who took your money.
You know a guy.
He's not buying it.
Tess.
You of all people should know, Terry. In your hotel, there's always someone watching.
Ooh. I love the music choice for this scene.
Wait, that's my husband.
I knew what I was doing.
I didn't. How long will you be?
3 to 6 months, I guess.
I know this is supposed to be like all cutesy and shit, but God, I could never be with someone that was like routinely in prison. It doesn't matter if they look like George Clooney. That's Don Cheadle, right? Him and this other actor, I get mixed up all the time, and I always have. I will see when the credits roll. Oh, we get a 3 to 6 months later. I was expecting credits to roll. Ugh, I want a burger now.
I hope you were the groom.
Ted Nugent called. He wants his shirt back.
$13 million, and you drive this piece of shit cross-country to pick me up?
Brad Pitt right now is giving me Guy Pearson Memento vibes.
Stopped and picked up your personal effects. Hope you don't mind.
I'm not sure these belong to me.
We need to get Rusty a girl.
There's a women's prison down the road.
Really? I guess you know someone really gives a shit about you if they're willing to steal $160 million from your partner and then also go to prison, but that's not the kind of love that I'd be after. If you enjoyed my reaction to Ocean's 11, best way to let me know is by clicking that like button and also leave me a comment. Let me know if you'd be interested in me watching the other ones. I did quickly look them up. We got Ocean's 12, Ocean's 13, Ocean's 8, which I now remember. Yes, those are all things. They exist. So if you are interested, let me know. I am definitely up for more heist movies. I feel like this is a genre that I don't have a lot of watch time in. And I definitely love when like good plans are made. The executions are successful. I would also be interested in movies where they're not successful because I think that would be really fun. So yeah, definitely let me know your suggestions. I have a form that I link in every single video description. It's just a Google form. Put your movie suggestions there. If you do suggest heist movies specifically, definitely put that as the genre instead of like crime or thriller. And then that way I can grab heist movies to make future polls with, that sort of thing. Thank you in advance. There are two moments in this movie that really stick out to me as being my favorite. The first is when Matt Damon as Linus was acting as the gaming commissioner to fool Benedict, and he was questioning Frank. That whole scene was just really fun. But starting from the moment that he like was the gaming commissioner and like got in front of Benedict, I don't know. I was hoping that he would really succeed with it. I know the character was nervous and Matt Damon was acting that really well. That was just a good moment. And then my second favorite was the reveal that it was them that was the SWAT team, and they had pre-recorded the videos to show to Benedict, and they had filmed them in their like mock setup. Makes sense now why they rebuilt the vault in their own house. Wasn't a house, it was a building. You know what I mean? Anyway, that was a really cool reveal because I don't recall them talking about that in the movie before it happened. So that was cool. I feel like that was done to maybe like trick the audience a little bit and make them think that, oh no, Benedict's onto them, when no, they had it under control the whole time. Although maybe I just missed something huge and that could probably be it. I don't know. The cast in this movie was super fun. I feel like the cast was super varied and awesome. I thought the diversity of the heist team itself was really good, with the exception of there was no woman on the team. I don't count Tess because she participated unknowingly. And also just finding the phone and handing it to Benedict, that didn't really do a whole lot. Like, yes, she was essential in the end, but yeah, she wasn't actively involved like the rest of them were. As for the men that were involved, love the diversity of everyone's strengths and talents and just involvement in this. And I love when teams have everyone be such an essential person that the plan can't work if one of them fails or backs out for whatever reason, right? So everyone here had a super important role. And speaking of that, when I did not see Don Cheadle's name in the credits, I was very confused by that because I needed to confirm if it was Don Cheadle or Tim Meadows, because I don't know what it is about those two actors, but I get them mixed up constantly. My eyes think they look alike a lot. So anytime I'm watching an older movie where one of them is starring in it and they're younger, I don't know, I get them mixed up. So I was watching the credits waiting for one of those names to appear, and I was looking for Basher, and I was shocked when he wasn't there. So then I went on a Google digging research wormhole to be like, why was Basher not credited in Ocean's 11? Anyway, come to find out that Don Cheadle wanted his name to be like above the title for billing alongside Brad Pitt and all those guys, and he was denied that. So then he was just like, well, fine, take my fucking name out the credits then altogether. So he is not credited at all. I didn't know this was a thing until I started doing movie reactions where actors can like negotiate where their name goes in the credits and how their name is in the credits, with the whole like and with and like, you know, the order of the names and all of that. That whole thing is fascinating to me. It makes me wonder, like, how long actors talk about this. Who do they talk to? Is it the director that makes that decision, or is it a marketing team? Like, I have no idea. And it's also like part of their pay, is it not? Or their pay can be affected by where they are in the credits list and how they're credited, right? Anyway, that whole thing is so fascinating to me. I should really look more into that. Another thing I loved so much about this movie was the transitions. I pointed it out a few times when it happened and just thought it was really cool. I will say that a lot of the transitions kind of reminded me of like PowerPoint back in the day, like when I used to have to make presentations for school and college and stuff. I know that's a weird comparison to draw, and people may hate me for that, I don't care, but that's what it reminded me of. But I loved it. Thought it was really fun, very engaging, eye-catching. It was cool. Overall, I really enjoyed this movie. I would definitely rewatch it, and I am interested in watching the others. I'm interested in watching more heist movies, and yeah, with that, I'm really excited to go to Letterboxd now to see what some other people have to say. So let's go. First up, 4.5-star review. Amazing. Brad Pitt literally got paid to sit around and eat the whole movie. Why can't I have a job that easy? There was an earlier review I saw by someone who actually listed off every single thing that he ate in this movie. It's a long list. I don't pay that close enough attention, apparently. I love this review that says, watched it without a Letterboxd quip in mind, aka it is perfect. I need the Letterboxd quips though. I'm reminded when I look through these reviews of how many people like love Brad Pitt and think he's the hottest man alive, and I don't see it personally. I never have. He's not a bad looking man. I'm not gonna say he's unattractive. Like, he is an attractive man, but he's just not my type. Finally, a 4-star review. I never pay attention to fashion in movies, but oh my god, I could learn a thing or two about Clooney or Pitt in this awesome film. I will admit, they both were dressed very immaculately. We'll go with that. All right, and now it is that time of the video where I turn it to you and ask you to leave your comments down below. Let me know your thoughts on Ocean's 11. What do you like about it? I gave you two of my top moments in the movie. You let me know yours. Make sure to include some kind of money-related emoji, either the face with the dollar signs for eyes or an actual, like, cash emoji or credit card or dollar sign, something like that. Very excited to read your comments, and just once again, thank you so much for watching this with me, and thank you to everyone on Patreon for your financial support as well. If you are not yet subscribed to the channel, click here to do so to get notified of future reactions, and click here to watch something else of mine, and we'll see you in the next reaction. Take care, everyone.